Good afternoon. Welcome to this press conference. I'm glad to welcome back Commissioner Reynders, who is becoming a frequent guest to our press room. A lot going on free movement issues. Today, the Commissioner will present to you an update of the recommendation on coordination of travel measures in relation to the pandemic. Commissioner, please, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, and good afternoon. It's a pleasure to meet you again for another important announcement of free movement. I'm frequent here in this press room. I'm not yet a frequent flyer. Maybe with such a kind of new evolution, it will be the case in the next weeks and months. 10 days ago, the European Parliament and the Council reached a provisional agreement for a common EU digital COVID certificate. The EU digital COVID certificate will facilitate free movement for all Europeans across the European Union. It will be accepted wherever you go. Last week, the European Council called for the revision of the Council recommendation on free movement by mid-June. And today, I'm presenting to you the Commission's proposal to update this Council recommendation. With the EU digital COVID certificate, the Parliament and the Council agreed on an important principle. If you have an EU digital COVID certificate, you should not be subject to additional restrictions unless this is necessary to protect public health. In today's proposal, we propose how this principle could be translated into practice. A coordinated approach is essential for the internal market and also for EU citizens who need to know what the situation is before deciding to travel, spending money, or booking holidays. This is why the Commission has been so determined to coordinate Member States' restrictions to free movement from the beginning of the pandemic. It is about creating certainty for people. What we are proposing today is, first, we propose no travel-related testing or quarantine for fully vaccinated or recovered persons. This is already practiced in many member states, and this should be independent from where you travel from or where you are traveling to. We propose a common understanding of who a fully vaccinated person is in the context of travel. That means 14 days after having received the last dose. Particularly, with your EU digital COVID certificate for vaccination or recovery, you will be able to provide reliable proof that you do not need to be subject to additional restrictions. Second, we are proposing to give more clarity to people who do not fall into these two categories. Here, the measures should be adapted to the color of the zone you are traveling from. When you come from a green area, no restrictions should be applied to you. When you come from an orange area, you could only be asked to do a test. And when you come from a red area, you could be asked to quarantine until you receive a negative test result. Quarantine should not apply if you have a negative pre-departure test certificate. And finally, we propose to keep test and quarantine as recommended for dark red areas or areas with high numbers of coronavirus variants. And so it's important to see that there is no discrimination between the different categories of certificate. If you have a certificate of recovery, vaccination, or test, it's possible to travel from green, orange, or red zone. It's just for the dark red that there is a difference with the test, because third, we all know that the current situation with different testing requirements creates confusion. This is why we propose today standard validity periods for travel-related tests. We are proposing that PCR tests are considered valid for 72 hours, and rapid antigen tests, where a member state accepts them, for 48 hours. Again, the EU digital COVID certificate will allow you to prove you have a valid test. Once in practice, these recommendations will support the functioning of the internal market and allow families to reunite or go on a well-deserved holiday together. To make this even easier for families, we are proposing that minors who are traveling with their parents should not be required to quarantine when their parents are exempt, for example, because they are vaccinated. We also propose that Member States agree to exempt children under six from travel-related testing. At the same time, we need to remain vigilant because the pandemic is not over yet. This has been made very clear by the emergence of new variants of the virus. This is why we are proposing an emergency break, which allows Member States to reintroduce measures also for people who have been vaccinated or have recovered, if the epidemiological situation in a country deteriorates rapidly. This should allow Member States to react quickly to variants of concern that increase transmissibility, that cause stronger symptoms, or that affect the efficacy of vaccines. To have a good overview of the spread of variants, we propose that Member States agree on a minimum level of genome sequencing of positive samples. We are still in a pandemic, and we need to constantly adapt ourselves to ensure free movement without putting public health at risk.
Ladies and gentlemen, this proposal comes at a time where we have seen infection rates go down and vaccination rates go up across the European Union. Our intention today is clear. The Commission is not looking to impose restrictions that ought to be applied, such as tests or quarantines. Those decisions remain the responsibility of Member States and is linked to the situation that is specific to each Member State. However, what we recommend through this proposal is that if certain Member States decide to impose restrictions to free movement, then this recommendation offers a coordination key to ensure that these decisions are proportionate and non-discriminatory for all European citizens. We now have a political agreement for this EU digital COVID certificate. This is an important step. Without this agreement, we would have had a fragmented approach with 27 Member States and 27 different systems. Through joint commitment of the European institutions and Member States, we are deploying a common system accessible to all in Europe. We would encourage Member States to deliver, wherever possible, EU digital COVID certificates whenever national legislation allows it. Member States should then adopt a common approach on the way in which these EU digital COVID certificates should be used for travelling. Today, we propose to the Council to clarify the manner in which this could be achieved. Some Member States have already announced that they would like to extend the use of the digital certificate in other situations concerning public life, such as access to concerts or other events. This is possible if there is a national legislation in place authorising this type of practice. However, I would strongly encourage Member States to make use of the EU digital COVID certificate in these situations as well. This will enable a guarantee to ensure that there is greater consistency and harmonisation for all citizens who wouldn't have to then ask for different types of documents to both travel and have access to events. Now, I would like to ask the Council to adopt this new proposal promptly so as to ensure that the EU digital COVID certificate is there in time for the summer. This is the way in which it is established, what a person has, how a person has been experiencing this. This is a proposal that the Commission makes to the Council, and it's now up to the Council to discuss this so as to ensure that this can be adopted by mid-June. Thank you very much.